Well, Ketubot Perek Yud Gimel, Mishnah Che, 8th Mishnah in the 13th chapter, last chapter of Masechet Ketubot. We continue to talk about the halachot of Admon. So, very interesting cases. Admon presents a lot of really interesting cases. Samotzi Shtar Chov Al Chaveiro. Ruvain takes out a Shtar Chov that says, Shimon owes me money. Okay? And it's signed, and Shimon says, yeah, it's no problem. I mean, whatever. There was a debt. Okay? Okay, and but Shimon says, I don't owe you the money anymore. Shimon says that the debt was already paid. Now, how does Shimon say the debt was paid? Hala motzi shemachar lo et hasadeh. So the other guy says, listen, okay, Shimon says, yes, I borrowed money from you, but it was already paid, because after it was already paid, I bought your field from you, and I gave you a ton of money for the field. You know, you gave me the field, I took the field, you took the money. Okay, so if I owed you money, let's delete that. If I owed you money, Shimon says to Reuben, if I owed you money, when I paid you for the field, you should have said, listen, the money you gave me was for the money you owed me. But you didn't say that, you took the money for the field. That's what the Mishnah says. Amotzi shtar chov al chaveiro. Reuben has a shtar chov, he says, you owed me money, I have a contract. V'hala hotzi shemachar lo et hasadeh, and the love. Hala, the other one, the borrower of the money originally, hotzi alav shtar mechira meucheret neshtar halavai. He brings out a contract of sale that's later than the loan. Veomer shtarcha mizuyaf o parua. Either that first loan is mizuyaf, fake o parua. I paid it. Let's assume paid. Shim ayiti chayav lecha. If I owed you money, lo ayiti mocher li et hasadeh. You would never have sold me the field. You should have taken the money that I had to pay for the money. If I really owed you the money, if this debt was real, then when I paid you for the field, when I gave you the money, you should have said, oh, by the way, that's for the money you owed me. But you didn't. You sold me your field. Admon Omer, Admon says, Yachol hu sheyomar. Okay. He could say, okay, Ilu ayiti chayav lecha, haya lecha lipara et shelcha, kishamacharta li et hasadeh. That's what we said. If I really owed you the money, then you should have paid back, you should have taken back the money that you were owed when you sold me the field. But since you didn't, it shows that the original debt is no longer extant, or the original contract was fake. Mechachamim amim, chachamim say no. Ze haya pikeach shemachar lo et hakarka, mipnei shehu yachol limashkeno. No, he says that the original guy, the first guy, he is owed the money, and he was intelligent, he was smart that he sold him the field. Because now he can take it as collateral. He says, listen, Reuven knows Shimon owes the money. Reuven also knows that Shimon has money now. Maybe he'll like run out of money. So you know what? Instead of getting Shimon to pay me, he'll never pay me. I don't know. He has the ability to get out of paying me. He's like, I got investments or whatever. I'll sell him the field. And then once he has the field, if Shimon claims that he can no longer pay me, now he has property for collateral for the money that he owes me. Meaning, the Chachamim say Reuven is a smart person because now knows Shimon has something that can force him to pay him back. Okay, he's the pikeach shemachar lo et hakarka, very smart. Liquid money is easy to hide, so therefore now achshav yitol et hakarka. Now he's going to be able to take the land instead. Now the Gemara talks about the Bar Tudor has a whole thing about, is it a case where some places they would pay money first? And then they would give the land, some they would give the money, land first and pay the money. You can look it up to understand specifically what case our Mishnah is talking about. We'll stop here and dedicate our learning to the memory of my father, Harav Simcha ben Yitzchak Kalman. Have a good day.